YouTube, you guys have been really sweet and telling me that you've liked my hair in a lot of recent videos, so I'm going to be making a tutorial on how I use my Cortex 4-in-1 curling wand. So this is the 1 1/2 inch barrel, non-conical, just a straight barrel, and this is the one that I love using the most, but as the name says, it's 4-in-1, so it actually does come with multiple sizes, and as I've joked about before, it does look as though I have this growing dildo collection in my bathroom because of all these different attachments. It starts out with the 1/2 to 1 inch graduated for the girl who's trying to work her way up to 1 inch. The 3/4 inch, which is non-conical, 1 1/4 inch, and then the 1 1/2 inch, which as I said, will be the one that I will be demonstrating today. And it just comes in this box, as you can see, they're all laid out there. So you could keep the box and keep them in there, but I just put them in a basket. And it's really easy to use. It also comes with a heat-resistant glove, but I don't really use those. I don't know. I just prefer to burn my fingers, essentially. I also normally use a heat protectant spray, but I already kind of sprayed it in my hair when I was upstairs really quick. So that's already in there, so you won't be seeing me spray it. But, you know, I don't really have a recommendation of a heat protectant spray that I love, so just use whatever you have. And I got this curling iron for about $50 or $60 on Amazon. It says like full price was like $200 or something, but that's just ridiculous. But it's a really good curling iron, and normally like detachable ones are pretty shitty, but in my opinion, this one is actually quite nice. So it's been heating up for a while, and it's got a pretty high heat setting going right now that I pumped it up to. So it's gonna be just really, really quick, simple curls to kind of get a beachy look. So that's what I'm going for. And I'm just going to take the top of my head in the beginning and pull that back just because I want to deal with the bottom stuff first and the top stuff last. So super cute hairstyle. So this is the end of my hair tutorial. You just do this and then you look really good. Yeah, okay, so separate my hair. I always find it easier if I just separate my hair into two sections. And then as I do it, I just pull it and throw it behind my shoulder. And I try to go from the back, so it's just easier to work yourself from the back to the front, in my opinion, because then you don't have the curls like in front of you as you're trying to work. And I take pretty big sections. I don't like actually section the hair because I want it to be like a little bit messy, but I just take really, really big sections and you just wrap it around. And I hold it on there for not very long. And sometimes I kind of keep the end a little bit straight. It gets a little bit more of a beachy look. And then I let it go. But it's just like really light and flowy, as you can see right there. It'll be easier as I go up to the front. So cue the fast forwarding. I'm now going to do this whole little section of my head really, really fast. So here is the bottom layer of my hair. Super simple, just easy waves. Voila! Okay, now I will take the top part out and start up there. And by the way, that probably, even though it was fast forward for you guys, it probably took me about 3-4 minutes tops, maybe. Really simple, because if you heat it up pretty at a high setting and you want these loose curls that kind of fall out a little bit, you just want to put them on literally for probably about like 5 seconds. I don't know. When you want the curls to last a lot longer, then obviously put them on for a much longer time, like 10 seconds or something. But don't fry your hair. Thank you. And as you can see, I don't straighten the two front bits of my hair according to like when I do the sides. I kind of like to save these for the end because I try to deal with them as gently as possible. I'm just gonna curl this little bit because I don't want them in there. But I try to curl those as gently as possible and pretty far down the root. So I try to do them next to each other just so that's the most even as possible so I can try to replicate the technique I used on one side, because sometimes I forget, like I'll get it looking really good on one side and then not on the other, and because I part my hair somewhat in the middle, it can be a little difficult. So sometimes I kind of just like go like that with the wand just to straighten out the top bits of the hair, and then I go down the barrel and like pretty loose like this. It's not like crunched up on the barrel, it's quite loose. 1, 2, 3. And then that's how I get that kind of curl. And then I go to this side. This, like, is the joy of having this really fucking annoying cowlick. Like, I want to get rid of that. In life, I just want to get rid of that. So, try to replicate exactly how I put it on the other side, even though sometimes I'm not really that successful. Get my fucking cowlick out of the way. And then I just like to mess up my hair. And this is kind of the end result in terms of just the loose beachy waves. And my next step is I will take my favorite kind of brown shaded powder for dry shampoo, and I just go along these ends of my hair just because I have all these little baby hairs that can get really greasy. And I just take care of those because I washed my hair yesterday. Okay, so now those are taken care of, and my next thing will be to take this Living Proof Prime Style Extender. It is weightlessly perfecting, weatherproofing, time-saving, and they say to kind of put this on before your thing, but I actually like putting it on after as just kind of, I don't know, maybe it makes it a little piecey. I got this in some Sephora like VIB hair sampler kit thing, but I just take a small amount of this kind of whitish gel, pop it between my hands, and just kind of work it into the hair, scrunching, floofing, pulling, you know, trying to replicate that like easy tousleness that hairdressers always have, where they just seem like they're just so effortlessly making your hair perfect. Focus it on the ends too, towards the top, maybe get some of those flyaways out of the way, and then I move on to hairspray. And my favorite hairspray is the Bumble and Bumble Spray to Mode for when I do curl looks, but I don't have that with me right now. I haven't repurchased it in a while, but this is the Bumble and Bumble Classic, which is a great strong hold. So when I'm doing like pulled back, just like fierce face only looks where I want all my hair out of the way, this is really great, but it's also good for holding a curl. I just prefer the Spray to Mode because it's one of those like really workable sprays. And I just kind of, oh, I should put my, I'm going to put this inside my shirt because I don't want my necklace to get ruined with the spray because it's one of those cheapy Topshop ones. And then I just kind of spray my hand a little bit, get rid of the flyaways. So that is, pull my necklace back out. Okay, so let me get back. This is one of my favorite hair looks to do at the moment. And my favorite thing about it is like as the day goes on, the curls just kind of fall out a little bit more. They get a little bit more beachy because I don't necessarily actually love it. Like straight out right now. I don't love how it sits around my face. I still haven't perfected like getting it perfect around my face. So I put it behind my ears. I kind of go about my day. So sometimes I just wake up the next morning and I'm like, I love my hair. Throw some dry shampoo around the crown and on the sides of my head and I'm good to go for like a day, sometimes even two. The hair just lasts forever. So thank you guys so much for watching, and if you're curious about how I did this makeup look, there will be a link in the description box to the Get Ready With Me video for this makeup look. Also, if you're curious as to how I use my conical wand, which is a Hot Tools 1 inch to 1.5 inch, I believe, I will be also posting the tutorial I did with that wand down in the description box below. So thank you guys so much for watching, and have a great day. Bye!